The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus went through the grain fields on the Sabbath. His disciples were hungry, and they began to pluck heads of grain and to eat. But when the Pharisees saw it, they said to him, "Look, your disciples are doing what is not lawful to do on the Sabbath." He said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he was hungry and those who were with him? How he entered the house of God and ate the showbread, which it was not lawful for him to eat, nor for those who were with him, but only for the priests? Or have you not read in the law how on the Sabbath the priests in the temple profane the Sabbath and are guiltless? I tell you, something greater than the Sabbath, than the temple is here. And if you had known what this means, 'I desire mercy and not sacrifice,' you would not have condemned the guiltless, for the Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, the word of the Lord came through the prophet Isaiah to Hezekiah that soon he will depart this world. But in the first instance, the Lord regarded the person of Hezekiah. And Hezekiah, in turn, prompts the hearts of the Lord to remember how he himself has been faithful to the covenant, how he has been diligent, and because of that, the Lord extended his life. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, that should strike a chord in our hearts, on our chest, that can we stand before the Lord and say to him, "Remember how I have been faithful before you." Can I stand before the Lord and say to him, "Remember how I have been faithful since I was ordained a priest, or how I have been faithful since I was baptized"? Can people who are married stand before the Lord and say to him, "Remember how I have been faithful, how I have been faithful in my words, how I have been faithful in my emotions"? Can all of us stand before the Lord, strike our chest and say, "We have been faithful before the Lord"? Beloved in the Lord, the Lord did not only hear the voice, the prayer of Hezekiah, he also showed his mercies to the people of Israel. So you see that we live for one another, that the positions we occupy, either private, business or public matters, or else they are also important. They have a relationship, they have something to do with us. And so, the life we live, as it were, influences things that happen in our offices, influences things that happen in our homes. And so, beloved, we must be careful. In the overall, we see the mercies of God, even in the life of Hezekiah. But again, in our own time, all of us will give thanks to God. Because when the Lord looks into our lives, he will see the faithfulness and the mercies of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Because that is our redeeming point. And that is what we see in the Gospel of today. That the Lord Jesus has come to express the mercies of God. Beloved, that is what we should celebrate. And if we celebrate the mercies of God in our lives, in our families, in the work of our hands, let us as well not take that mercy for granted. Let us as well show that mercy to our brothers and sisters.